Hi, today we're going to work a few more problems from section 1.6, numbers 31 and 34. Alright, for 31, it's kind of a big problem. It says find the domain, and it gives us this really nasty looking function here, square root of x times x minus 2. And the way we're going to do this is in the form of a sine chart, because we know that this expression has to be greater than or equal to 0. So we know that our critical values here are 0 and 2. So we'll draw a little number line. 0 and 2. We know it can be 0 or 2 because the square root of 0 is 0. And what we're going to do here is plug in a test point from each section to see what the sine is. If we plug in a negative, obviously we're going to get a negative. Times a negative is a positive. If we plug in, let's say, 1, 1 times 1 minus 2 is negative 1, so that's negative. And if we plug in 3, 3 times 3 minus 2, 1 is 3, positive. So now we know that the domain here is going to be from negative infinity to 0 inclusive in union with inclusive 2 to infinity. Alright, part B says it's almost the same thing. It's the square root of x times 2 minus x. Again, we're going to do this in the form of a sine chart. This has to be greater than or equal to 0. Our critical values at this time, however, are 2 and, well, okay, again, the same thing, 0 and 2. Okay, and so we're going to do our test point again. We'll plug in negative 1. Negative 1 times 2 minus a negative 1 is 2 plus 1 is 3. And 3 times negative 1 is negative. Here we have, we'll plug in 1. 1 times 2 minus 1, 1, 1, all positive. And here we'll plug in 3 perhaps. 3 times 2 minus 3, negative 1, so we get a negative value here. And so this time, even though it's just a little change, our whole domain changes and we get 0 inclusive to 2 inclusive. Alright, moving over here to part C, we're going to do this one a little differently. We don't need to do a sine chart because there's no square roots. You'll notice that this is the same thing as x, we'll just leave that as x squared, and on the bottom we have x times x minus 2. Now, the first time I did this, I just canceled that out, but you can't do that. That's a mistake. You just need to look at your denominator and know that neither of these factors can be equal to 0. So you come over here and you'd say x cannot equal 0 and x minus 2 cannot equal 0. All right, solve here and you'll get x cannot equal 2. So overall, x cannot equal 0 or 2. And we can write that in interval notation as negative infinity to 0, can't include it, union 0 to 2, union 2 to infinity. Sorry, I kind of ran out of board there. And then the last one here, we can also do in the form of a sine chart. We'll rewrite this, square root of x squared over x minus 2. Alright, we can do it the same way. We know that this has to be greater than 0, so we can write like that. And our critical values, again, will be 0 and 2. Now note this time that it will not be inclusive because they're on the bottom, they're on the denominator. So we do our little sign number line here, 0, 2. So actually I could erase this and just say greater than 0, so it can't be equal to. We'll plug in a test point, let's say negative 1. We'll get negative and negative, so all that'll come out to be positive. Plug in a 1, maybe, we'll get 1, 1. Get a negative value here. Plug in 3, 9, 3, and a positive value here. So this time our domain is going to be negative infinity to 0, non-inclusive, union 2 to infinity. And that's that problem. We got one more over here, number 34. They give us a function, f of x equals x squared plus 4x. And they ask us to find this laundry list of values here. So for the first one, it says f of negative x. So basically all we have to do is plug in negative x. we get negative x squared plus 4 times negative x, which equals x squared minus 4x. Over here it just says we take our entire function and make everything negative, so that'll give us negative x squared minus 4x. Here we plug in 1 over x, and we'll get 1 over x quantity squared plus 4 times 1 over x, which is the same thing as 1 over x squared plus 4 over x. And if you wanted to simplify it even further, you could find a common denominator here of x squared, and you'd get 1 plus 4x over x squared. Then we have to do 1 over the entire function f of x, and this will give us 1 over x squared plus 4x. I think what they're trying to do here is show you that f of 1 over x and 1 over f of x are not the same thing. Anyways, the next one is f of square root of x. So we have square root of x squared plus 4 times the square root of x. And the square root of x squared is usually x, so we'll put that. And plus 4 square root of x. Okay, and last but not least, the square root of the entire f of x, which will be the square root of x squared plus 4x. And that should be all the answers for you.